Let us see. In this video, we learn how to derive shape functions for an axis symmetric triangular element, that is axis symmetric system. Shape functions for it, it is a special case. Already I have done a videos on these shape functions for bar elements I have derived, and also I have derived a quadratic element, shape function for quadratic element also. And also I have derived shape functions for CST element, that is constant strain triangles. So in this description there is a link. So if you want to, so click on description. So description link. So in this video we have discussed we have derived the shape function for axis symmetric triangular element. You know very well about axis symmetric. So I am repeating. Axis symmetric means the boundary condition is same from its axis. From its axis, the geometry is same, like our window. So bank is, if you see bank is, so from its axis, so entire component is symmetric. Okay, material same, symmetric, boundary conditions symmetric, and materials also symmetric, and applying load is also symmetric. Such type of components we call it as axis symmetric element. Okay, let us. So that is what I am saying. That is concluded. I want to conclude that all revolving components comes under axis symmetric element. That is axis symmetric triangle. That is axis symmetric problem. Okay, it is a special case. Okay, I am repeating. Material is same from its axis. Geometry is same from its axis, and boundary conditions are also same from its axis. Such type of elements we call it as axis symmetric element. For example, so in this video we have to derive, that is in this video I want to derive shape function for axis symmetric element. So if you see, so for example I want to take one element, axis symmetric element, such as this is the one of axisymmetric element. Let us consider. I am considering only after some sectional, after cutting as a section, so like this. So it forms a triangle. This is the triangle. Okay. So I want to generate shape function for this triangular element. Okay. In this video, we learn how to derive a shape function for its for axisymmetric triangular element. Okay. This is the node mark. Every node has it is 2D element. Okay. Axisymmetric element is 2D element. So because of this reason, every node has 2 degree of freedom system. Every degree, every node has 2 degree. That is, so for example, every node has 2 degree because it is a 2D element. That is, every node has 2 degree of freedom system. For example, if you take one node, so this is node 1, node 2, this is the node 3. So I want separate element, I want to write this is the element. Okay? This is the node 1, node 2, node 3. Every node has 2 degree of freedom. That is 2 degree of freedom. And next, and typically horizontally and okay. Horizontally we call it as U1, U2 and U3. And let us write here U1, U2 and U3 are nodal displacement, that is nodes displacement
Elam, 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 arc direction, that is radial direction. Okay, this is the radial direction. Actually, it is radius, radial direction. Okay, this is radial direction. And W1 and W2 and W3. That is W1, W2 and W3 are nodal displacement. Displacement along. So I'm using similar words because U1, U2, U3 is displacement, but it is not direction, nodal displacement. W1, W2, W3 is also nodal displacement, but it is in vertical direction or it is in along W direction. Okay, along up Z direction. So this is the Z direction. Direction. Okay. Next, let us write. So some cases we call it as in some textbooks follows U1 V1. So that is also correct. So I am changing. V1, V2, V3 and this vertical. Mostly they are using V1, V2, V3. That's why I am using V1, V2 and V3 are the nodal displacement along Z direction. Okay? Next. Here three nodes. 1, 2, 3. Three nodes. So because of this laser, there are three shape functions. Okay? So let us write. N1, N2, N3 are the shape functions for this accessibility for this element. Okay, for this element. Okay, next.
Displacement
one displacement along x direction or x sorry along y direction and one unit displacement in that is overall one displacement in w direction w1 or v direction v1 plus n1 v1 n2 v2 plus n3 v3 this is the relationship more important to finding nodal displacement if you know if you get nodal displacements nodal that is overall nodal displacement or displacement of the element easily you can calculate easily the strengths and the stresses also okay that's why so I want to find out each and every nodal displacement okay nodes displacement that is u1 u2 u3 and v1 v2 v3 so after getting the nodes nodal displacement nodal displacement so you can calculate easily overall nodal displacement or overall elemental displacements okay so let's find out u1 we know very well that is polynomial functions so polynomial function by using polynomial by using polynomial functions polynomial that is it gives some relation in between the some constants that is regarding that particular element okay and displacement will give some relation so right u1 is equal to a1 plus a2 that is r1 a2 plus z1 a3 okay this is the two directions only r direction and z direction u1 and u2 is equal to a1 plus r2 a2 plus z2 it is equal to z2 it is equal to z2 it is z2 into a3 this is one equation this is another equation and u3 is equal to u3 is equal to what a1 plus r3 r3 a2 plus z3 a3 these are the polynomial function for u that is polynomial functions so by using these relations we will get that is these are supporting equations that is basic equations to find out nodal displacement okay these are polynomial functions so mostly these type of polynomial functions are used to find out shape functions okay we have here let's find out so these three equations can be written in matrix form so that is u1 u2 and u3 that is equal to this side okay na so u1 u2 u3 and 3 by 3 matrix and this one is u1 a1 a2 and a3 okay na so I'm writing in matrix form these three equations I'm writing in matrix form so this is 1 r1 and z1 1 r2 z2 and 1 r3 z3 so this is the matrix okay na this is the matrix we will get it next it is just like so bottom there is no space okay I'm writing here so just like u matrix okay this one like u matrix and displacement matrix okay next this one is it is d matrix okay transform matrix like that is and a matrix some constant matrix okay so this matrix is like this so this d is centered in this side that is we will get then d inverse u into d inverse that is u inverse into it is equal to a that that is finally we got like this. We got like this. U is U into D inverse. D inverse into A. Okay, we got this. So if here, if you find D inverse, so generally you will get straight function. That is, first initially we have to find out D inverse. So let's find it. D inverse means cofactors of D transpose. So cofactors D of transpose. This is the formula actually, cofactors of D. So cofactors means C21, C12, C13, C22, sorry, 21, C. These are the cofactors. Okay, cofactors of D. You know cofactors of D. Cofactors means, sorry, D inverse. Actually, it has a formula. D inverse is equal to D inverse is equal to H and dy delta d. Okay, so adjoint d is equal to cofactors of d transpose. This is the d transpose. Okay, cofactors d transpose. So this we call it as adjoint. So we know the formula of for this d inverse. D inverse means adjoint d by delta d. We know adjoint d means cofactors of d. So cofactors means c11 c12 c13, these are the cofactors of d. These actually, this is the matrix d. So that's why I avoided writing cofactors here. Okay, I'm erasing this for the problem. I'm not erasing. So cofactors means C of ij, it is equal to minus 1 half I plus j into dm. Dm means where dm is minus minor matrix of D. Minor matrix means, so for example, I want to find out this C11. So this C11 minor matrix is R1, J2, R3. These are the minor matrix. Okay. So just I am representing one. Okay. Next find out C11. So first we have to find out C11, C12, C13. So after getting this C11, C12, so easily we can get not only spaces. Okay, sorry, safe functions. So first initially we have to find out C11, C12, so find out. So C11, it is equal to minus 1 half 1 into square root of 1 plus 1, that is 1 plus 1 into d mean. And then d means that is by the matrix, that is R2 Z3 minus Z2 R3 minus Z2 R3. Okay. So that is 1 plus 1, 2, that is minus 1 whole square, that is minus 1 into minus 1, that is plus 1. So I am getting, so finally I am getting R2 Z3 minus R3 Z2.
So this type of equation I am getting.
And next C11.
Okay. C12. That is this one.
So C12 means
so
minor matrix. This one and this one. We will eliminate 1 into Z3 and Z2 into 1.
That is first we should have time to have right minus 1. Its coefficient 1 plus 2 is 1 plus 2 into
in minus matrix 1 into Z3, that is Z3 minus Z2 into 1, Z2,
that is Z3 minus Z2. So, right,
1 into Z2, Z3, 1 into Z3 minus Z2 into 1.
Okay?
So, 1 plus 1, that is 3. Minus 1 to the power of 3 means that is minus 1. Here, Z2 minus Z1. So, minus 1. So, after multiplying minus 1, we will get Z2 minus Z2. Okay? Is it clear? Actually, here is Z2 minus Z3 minus Z1. Z2 minus 1 is after multiplying minus, minus 1 here. So that's why I am multiplying with minus after multiplication I will get Z2 minus Z3.
Next,
let's find out C13.
C13 is equal to minus 1 4 to the power 1 plus 3 into
its matrix. Matrix is 1 into R3 minus R2 into 1. So after multiplication, so we will get, that is here 1 plus 3 is 4, 1 minus 1 to the power of 4 is positive. That is minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. So all are minus 1. So after multiplication, minus 1 into minus 1. Like that, so it is positive.
Next, here 1 into R3 R3 minus R2 into 1 of R2.
So finally, you have got R3 minus R3. Okay, next, let's find out C21. Let's find out C21. It is equal to minus 1. Its cofactor 2 plus 1. 2 plus 1 into its minus matrix is R1 into Z3. R1 into Z3 minus Z1 into R3. Z1 into R3. So after multiplication, so I am getting like this. So minus 1 to the power 2 plus 1, that is 4, that is 2, 3. So that is here, 1 minus is there. And R1 into Z3. So after multiplying with minus, we will get Z1 R3 minus, that is R3 Z1 here, this component I am writing, so multiplication minus R1 Z3. This is the finally I got first. So R3 Z1 minus R1 Z3. Next, let us find out 2 cofactors of 2 D. 2 is so minus 1 of 2, that is 2 plus 2 into multiplication means 1 into Z3, this is the minor matrix, 1 into Z3, Z3, Z1 into 1, minus Z2, so here minus 1 is positive, so power of minus 1 to the power of 4 means positive 1, that is Z3 minus Z1. So finally, I got the Z3 minus Z1. Next, let's find out C23. It is equal to C23. So, that is the column, this row is cancelled. So, multiply 1 into R3, that is minus 1 to the power of 2 plus 3. Into 1 into R3. Okay,
minus 1 into minus R1 into that is R1. So 5 plus 3 is 5. Minus 1 to the power of 5 means 1 minus 1. Minus 1 into something that is R3 minus R2 means R1 minus R1 minus R2. Okay? R1 minus R3. Next, let's find out 3C 3 1 minus 1 4 to the power 3 plus 1 into so 3 1 this one this component R1 into Z2 R1 into Z2 okay R1 into Z2 minus Z1 into R2 minus Z1 into R2 so 3 plus 1 is 4, 1 is 1 to the power of 4, 4, that is minus, minus positive, positive, then I, this one is positive, finally I got R1, Z2, minus Z1, R2, right, like this, okay, R2, Z1, R2, Z1, okay, next one, 3, so C, C3, 2, so minus 1 to the power of 3 plus 2 into this 2, this form, that is 1 into Z2, Z2, okay, Z in, Z1 into minus 1, sorry, Z into 1, Z1, so 3 plus 5, 3 plus 2 power 5, minus 1 to the power of 5, minus 1. So minus 1 into multiply, that is Z1 minus Z2. Z1 minus Z2. Next, C33. C33. So C33. Okay? Minus 1 into R2, R2. That is right equation. So minus 1 to the power of 3 plus 3 into minus 1 into R2, R2 minus R1. So let's find out. So here it is equal to minus 1 to the power of 6, that is it is positive. Next, positive into R2 minus R1, that is R2 minus R1. Finally, I got C cofactors here. So write it in matrix form. Okay, the matrix form. So write it. That is, see these two cofactors. Write it in matrix form. Okay. So cofactors. Cofactors of B is equal to. So write it all the equations. That is, C 11 means R 2 Z 3. Minus R 3 Z2 and C 1 2 Z2 minus Z3. So
here, so
okay, next Z2 minus Z3 and here, sorry, here R3 minus R2. Okay, R3 minus R2 by next C2, C21, okay, that is R3 Z1 minus R1 Z, okay, next here Z3 minus Z1 and here Z1 minus R, okay. Next, next R1, R1 Z2 minus R2 Z1, next Z1, Z1 minus Z2, okay, left here R2 minus R1. So finally I got
four factors matrix here. So write this. So cofactors of B. This one is cofactors of B matrix. Cofactors of B. Okay. Next. But formula is cofactors B transpose. So transpose this one. So the formula is D inverse naught, that is adjoint, D is equal to cofactors of B transpose. This is the formula. So that's why. So this matrix is converted into transpose. Okay. Cofactors B matrix. So find out. So cofactors of D transpose is equal to, that is actually, so 3 by 3 matrix, so here also 3 by 3 matrix, R2 Z3 minus R3 Z2, that is columns is converted into rows and converted into columns. This column is converted into rows, that is R3 Z1 minus R1 Z3, and this one R1 Z2 minus R2 Z1. Okay, this column is converted into row Z2 minus Z3 and Z3 minus Z3 and this one Z1 minus Z3. And here this matrix, that is this column is converted into row column, row, that is R3 minus R2, R1 minus R3, so R2 minus R3. This is the final equation of cofactor transposition. So I'm getting it. Next, you know, delta of D. Actually, D matrix is 1, R1, R2, so we know very well about it. So but delta D is equal to 2A. Okay, so let's find out D inverse. D inverse is equal to adjoint D adjoint D by delta D. So actually this one is adjoint D. Okay, or this means cofactors of D transpose is the adjoint D. So you can write it is, so when delta D means 2A, 1 by, that is adjoint D means, so let's write it here. It is equal to cofactors of D transpose by delta D means 2A. So here write one. So D matrix D inverse, it is equal to 1 by 2A into cofactors. Cofactors, these are the cofactors. Write it. R2 Z3 minus R3 Z2 and R3 Z1 minus R1 Z3 R1 Z2 R2 minus R2 Z1 next Z2 minus Z3 and here Z3 minus Z1 here Z1 minus Z2 here R3 minus R2 R1 minus R3 R2 minus R1. Okay, so finally we got this equation. Okay, this is actually D inverse matrix, only D inverse matrix. We know the relation between the D inverse and relation U into D inverse is equal to A. Okay, like write it. Okay, write it. That is A means A1, A2, A3, that's that is. So I'm writing here. Okay, this equation is equal to A, it is equal to U into D inverse. Sorry, D inverse into U. Like that. D inverse. D inverse into U. Okay? So let's write it. So A means A1, A2, A3, it is equal to D means this is the D matrix, that is D inverse matrix into 2A into R2 minus R2 Z3 minus R3 Z2 and R3 Z1 minus R1 Z3 R1 Z2 minus R3 Z1. Next, Z2, Z3, Z3 minus Z1, Z1 minus Z2. Next, R3 minus R2, R1 minus R3, R2 minus R1. So we need and displacements U1, U2, and this is the finally you got for this equation. Just this equation is just like it's just like just like A1, A2, A3. It is equal to just like it is equal to 1 by 2A of alpha 1, beta 1, gamma 1, sorry, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. Just like alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, and beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, and gamma 1. Into U1, U2, U3. So have you
okay na?
So this one, this matrix is like this. Okay, alpha 1 means R2 Z3 and minus R3 Z2. Okay na? This is alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. Beta 1, beta 2, beta 3. Gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3. Just like. Okay? Just let. This is the alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3. Alpha. Okay? Just imagine. Where alpha 1 is this sort of element. And alpha 2 means this one. Okay? And alpha 3 means this one. Okay? Let find out. That is. So finally, we got A1, A2, A3. Equal to 1 by 2a into alpha 1, alpha 2. So finally we got one equation. Okay, let's find out. So we know that u it is equal to 1 r1 sorry r and z. Okay, into that is so just a simple write total equation and then I will convert it. So have you
appeared total? Okay, next.
Okay, right here. We know u is equal to a1 plus r a2 plus z a. Okay, so this equation will convert it into some matrix form. We will convert here. So u is equal to 1 r z into so a1 plus a2 and a3. This is the matrix form of matrix. So let substitute this a1 into a3 in this equation. Okay, so that is the nodal displacement. Interior displacement is equal to 1 r u, which is in terms of volume. Overall volume of function is like this. So
just I want this equation so converted into some matrix form. Next we will get A1 into A3. So this A1 into A3, this is the final, we got final equation. This final equation substitute with this matrix, we will get so 1 into 1 RZ into. So A1 into A3 means 1 by 2A of alpha 1, beta 1, sorry, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3, and U1, U2, and U3. Okay? Let's multiply. Multiply each and every one. First we have to multiply this matrix into this matrix, and then overall this matrix into so next matrix. So first we have to multiply this matrix into this matrix. So 1 by 3 is common factor for this all the elements. So then just I take common. Next multiply 1 into alpha 1. Alpha 1, 1 into alpha 1, 1 into alpha 1, alpha 1, okay, plus 1 into alpha 1, so U is equal to 1 into alpha 1, number 2 is common, 1 into alpha 1, alpha 1, R into plus, R into beta 1, plus, Z into gamma 1, okay, multiply, all complete are multiplied. Next, 1 into alpha 2, alpha 2, plus, R beta 2, plus, Z into gamma 2. Okay, next equation. 1 into alpha 3, R into Z, beta 3, R beta 3, next, Z into gamma 3, plus Z into gamma 3. Okay, this time I am multiplied only Z into gamma 3. Okay, next. See, and here is U1, U2, and U3. Okay? Just multiply all U into next. Multiply each and every one. That is 1 by 2A into so alpha 1 plus R beta 1 plus Z2 gamma 1. Into U1. Okay. So have you okay. Okay. Have you appeared? Or not? Okay. Plus alpha 2 plus R beta 2 plus Z gamma 2 into U2 plus alpha 3 plus R beta 3 plus Z to gamma 3 into U3. So finally I got like this. Okay? So it is just right. So this 2A is also centered in this. That is, I am applying, I will divide it with 2A entire equation. So I will get to U. So new, I will get the new form R beta 1 plus Z gamma 1 whole by 2A into U1 plus alpha 2 plus R beta 2 plus Z gamma 2 whole by 2A into U2 plus alpha 3 plus R beta 3 plus Z gamma 3 whole by 2A
So finally, I got this relation. So it just like U is equal to N1 U1 plus N2 U2 plus N3 U3. So just like this. So let's write it. So when N1 is shape function, N1 is alpha 1 plus R beta 1 plus Z gamma 1 whole by 2A. And N2 is the N2 alpha 2 plus R beta 2 plus Z gamma 2 whole by 2A. And N3 is alpha 3 plus R. So have you
appear? I'm okay. You got it.
So R beta 3 plus Z gamma 3 whole by 2E. So that is finally I got the shape function for the axisymmetric element, that is N1, N2, and N3. This shape function is very important for axisymmetric. This is the special condition actually. So that's why I am finding shape function for each element. Okay? This is N1, N2, N3. Finally I got it. Next, we know the relations in between U, V. This U and V is equal to. There is a, this enough for up to this is enough for any examination. Just I'm explaining each and every one here. Just U and V is equal to N1 0, N2 0, N3 0, and here 0, N1 0, N2 0, and N3. Okay, this is U1, U2, V1, N1, V1. Okay, U1, V1, U2, V2, U3, V3. This is the overall equation for that is overall displacements with respect to shape functions and the normal displacement. This is the relation. Okay, here one more condition is there. So all shape functions, summation of the shape function must be equal. So the type of element also called as axisymmetric. Okay, it is very mandatory shape functions. After getting these shape functions, we will find out strain displacement matrix. Okay, strain. This is very important subject point of view as well as exam point of view also. It is very essential. Okay, so learn each and everything here. Axisymmetric is a special case actually. So shape functions is plays an important role to calculate nodal displacements. Okay, that's why I'm generating these shape functions here.